And it's time to tell, cause I just can't keep it to myself. Somebody give me your microphone, or a megaphone, or a telephone.
I got a shirt.
You're gonna clap your hands, gonna wanna dance.
Hear what?
Good news, got that old make do. Got that joy coming through, got me feeling alright. Good news, got that skip in my step. Feel that beat in my chest. Got that love in my life. I'm talking good news. I got that good news. Yeah. I've been praying for so long. Believing that day would come. He heard me and he pulled me out. He put me right here for such a time as now.
Every that kind of way. I was breathing, but not alive. All my failures I've tried to hide. It was my truth till I met you. Cold my
oh, my name.
My heart is yours forever. Got a lion inside of those bones. Worship with us today. On behalf of Pastors Eddie and Sonia Gallegos, welcome to Living Word Inland Empire. It's that time of year for 2021 contribution letters. If you would like to receive your letter, please be sure to sign up at the foyer desk so we can email them out to you. Join us in remembrance of Jesus' sacrifice. We would love for you to be a part of this amazing opportunity to share the good news. Sign up today for our annual Easter production. You don't want to miss out, so be sure to sign up before January 26th. You can register today on Facebook or Instagram.
Hi, Living Word family. We want to invite you to be part of our Love My City Walk being held Saturday, February 5th. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah that He goes before us and He makes all the rough places smooth. And that's what we're believing for our city this year. Great things. Healing, salvation, increase, and peace like never before. But not only do we have to believe it and pray on it and think on it, we need to move in it as well. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to walk the walk and talk the talk. So on Saturday, February 5th, we are going to circle our city. We are going to come and declare in prayer and in love all the things that we know that God has for Grand Terrace. So starting today, please register you and your family via either our Facebook page or our website. click on the little link to register for the walk, and all instructions will be listed there as well. The deadline to register for our walk event is January 31st. There are going to be more details to come, so stay tuned. But please believe and expect with us for great things on February 5th. And don't forget to register. That is the first step. And together, as one body, as one family, we're going to remind Grand Terrace how much Jesus loves them and how much we love our city. Thank you and God bless.
Get excited, youth. Your next on-campus youth night will be held Friday, February 11th at 7 p.m. Be sure to invite somebody out because you guys don't want to miss it. We didn't forget about you, ladies. Join us for our women's Bible study held Friday, February 11th at 7 p.m. located in the cafe. We can't wait to see you there. And just a reminder, there's no childcare provided. Take a journey with us here at Living Word. We will be reading the Bible in 1 year. If you would like to follow along, you can do so by checking out our Facebook or Instagram posts. And if you are more hands-on, you can pick up a reading log today at the foyer desk. Come pray, believe, and expect with us every Monday night as we hold our prayer nights at 7 p.m. We can't wait to intercede with you. We would love for you to stay connected with us here at Living Word. The ways you can do so is by liking our Facebook page, subscribing to our YouTube channel, or following us on Instagram. And if you happen to miss a service, don't worry, we've got you covered. You can listen now by checking out our podcast. Feel free to check out our LW shop so you can see all our latest designs we have in stock. Cafe will be closed after service, but be sure to join us Sunday after service for food and fellowship. We're so excited to announce our new way of giving through Tithely. Please enjoy this short clip so you can see how to download the app so you're ready and set to give towards our ministry.
Hi everyone, and welcome to Tithely. As our world becomes more digital, we want to make giving to the church as easy as possible for you. So here's a quick way to give online. If you don't yet have the Tithely app on your device, first go to the App Store and search tithe.ly for both Apple and Android users. Once it is fully downloaded and opened, the welcome screen will ask you to log in. Now, if it's your first time giving on the app, you can create an account by simply entering your name and email. Then come up with a personal, secure password and PIN for double security. Tithely will securely store your information so that future giving is easier. From this main screen, you can type the name of your church in the search bar, select yours, and click Give Now to continue to the giving page. The app will then ask for your credit card information and save that to your account to make future giving easier. Now, simply enter the amount you would like to contribute to your church and press Give. It's that easy. And if you'd like to set up recurring contribution, you can simply select Recurring Giving. Now that you've set up your account, giving will be even easier next time. You won't need to enter your name or credit card. All you do is log in, select your church, and give. Although this way of giving may be new for you, you are still honoring the Lord with your contribution.
We're so excited for this new way of giving. So be sure to have the app downloaded and search for our name, Living Word, Inland Empire, and you're all ready and set to give towards our ministry. And just a reminder, we no longer have our giving platforms through Zelle, PayPal, or Square. Thank you so much for your understanding. Now it's time for tithes and offering. Let's open our hearts and get ready to give.
Give the Lord a good clap offering today. Amen. Amen. As we pick up today's tithes and offerings, as the ushers come forward, as we turn to Psalms chapter 55, verse 22. How many of you guys decided to be in the house of the Lord today? Amen. 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 Just pray for all those that are out there that are, you know, under the weather and not feeling good, that, you know, everything will be taken care of. Amen. But it says right here in Psalms chapter 55, verse 22, it says, cast your burdens upon the Lord and he will sustain you. He will never allow the righteous to be shaken. Amen. And how many of you guys know that when we cast our burdens upon him, he's able to take control of what the situation is? But how many of you guys know when we try to take the situation and put it in our own lives, how many know we only make it worse? We try to do it our own way. Only if I do this or do that. And God says, look, it just come to me and I'll take care of all your needs. I've learned this since I was young. I learned this since I was older. I've learned this all the time, that the quicker you go to God, the faster he can work. But the longer you take and the wrong attitudes and this and that we have is the way he's going to treat the situation. And pastors always said, you know what? If you sow in good ground, that you'll receive good. Amen? And that's why they've showed us that we sow in different things. But when it comes to our finances, that's the hardest thing to sow. Amen? And God says, look, I'm going to sustain you. And it even says in the Bible, in Malachi, that he won't even let the devil take your crops. He says, I'm going to protect everything. Why? Because you're righteous. Because you did what I told you to do. Because you give the 10% and you gave out of your heart and you've done all these things. So you're righteous in his eyes. So he's always going to protect everything that you have given. So as we give, we got to remember that we have to cast our burdens upon him and let him take care of it, because he'll always take care of your needs. How many guys can testify to that? Amen? There's so many testimonies about how God's taking care of people's families when they didn't even expect it. And we just want to bless that today. Just remember, cast your burdens upon him and he'll take care of everything. Amen? Let's pray for this offering today. Father God, we just come before you and we just thank you, Lord, for everything that you're doing in our lives. Being careful, Lord, to always put you first. Casting our burdens upon you, because you are the one that can take care of us. You are a true Father. You are a true Lord. You are a true Savior. And we just thank you, Father, for always being there for us. Always being there right on time. Always giving us more than enough, more than we deserve. As we just thank you, Lord, as we bless this offering today, as we give to you, and we believe in you for everything. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a good clap offering. If you need an envelope, slip your hand.
You are here as you lift your word. You are riding on our faith. We'll go over everything. You are seated in our faith. This is prophetic.
We're going to have a guest speaker today, our very own Pastor Rudy Chacon. Come on, let's give him a good clap offering. Amen.
Praise God. Hallelujah. It's good to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. Come on, let's put our hands together. Let's get excited. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. God is in this place. Hallelujah. Praising God, hallelujah, giving him all the glory, giving him all the honor for what he's doing in your life and in my life and in this ministry. Can somebody say amen? Amen. Praise God. I just want to thank God for Pastor Edgy and Sister Sonia and for welcoming me and my wife Betty into this church. And I thank the men's home and the women's home and this congregation, because we feel love in this place. We feel God in this place. We know that our pastor has a vision, amen. He's got a big vision, amen. Praise God, hallelujah. You may be seated, amen. Before I start, precious Father, Lord, first of all, I thank you and I give you all the glory and all the honor. I pray, Father God, that your anointing will fall in this place and touch every individual's life. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I pray in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Amen. If you have a Bible, turn your Bible to Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. Believe God and think big. Amen. I just want to tell you that I know Pastor Edgy since he was around 16 or 17 years old. Nobody wanted him, not even the school. I took him to the school. They didn't want him. But you know what? I'll tell you what. Jesus wanted him. Amen. And you know, he was a gang member. He was a nut. Amen. But how many know that God specializes in nuts? Amen. I could see God because I know him. And I know Sonia. Sonia was always with her family. She's a sweetheart. Hallelujah. She married Edgy. Amen. I remember going to their house. I remember going to their churches. But I'll tell you what. He thinks big. This church is powerful. You can look at it. Hallelujah. You see God's hand on his life, his wife, his family. Amen. I just thank God. Amen. I'm here in living word. Amen. Praise God. Come on. If we're going to clap, let's clap. Hallelujah. But with God, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he who comes to God must believe that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. How many know that you and I are called to seek God this evening? Amen. I'll tell you what, when you begin to seek God, God will reward you. I see God rewarding Pastor Edgy and Sister Sonia. I see the home. Amen. I go to the men's home and the women's home. They're blessed. They're excited. Hallelujah. Because why? Because Pastor Edgy has a vision. Amen. His wife. Hallelujah. God is raising up a powerful church right here in Grand Terrace. And we're a part of that. Hallelujah. You see, to be diligent, it means to press. It means to press in, amen. It means to take an effort. How many know the painting the church, amen, took an effort, amen, of persisting and doing this and getting the job done? I'll tell you what, I believe this evening in getting the job done. Hallelujah. Praise God. You see, Enoch, I want to talk about Enoch. He believed God. Enoch had faith. He had faith, and his faith was big. He thought big things. He walked with the Lord. How many know that we need to think ourselves big? Amen. We need to walk with the Lord. Amen. We can't walk with the devil no more. We can't straddle the fence. Amen. We got to walk with God and believe God that he's going to reward us for walking with him. You see, Enoch, he had fellowship with God. How many know that we have to have fellowship? And I'm not talking about eating pizza, hallelujah. That's not fellowship. Fellowship is talking with God, walking with God. Prayer is the number one key. Prayer, amen. And that's what Christians do less of. Prayer is powerful. It's communication with the Lord. How many know we have to have communication with the Lord? You see, our fellowship with God, church, is a brand new year. It's a brand new year. God is moving, amen. It's only the 12th day of this year, amen. And where are you at with God? We need to believe God and think big. We must have a desire to please him. How many ever had a desire? You know what? I remember when I first met my first wife. She was 13. I was 14. And I had a desire to go see her in the city of Watts. And I'll tell you what, when you have a desire and you make up your mind, how many know that you're going to do it? It don't matter the consequences. How many know there's consequences? Getting beat up every day for 6 months because I had to go to Watts. But I had a desire. How many know when you have a desire, the devil will beat you up, the devil will try to stop you, amen? But if you have a desire to serve God, you're going to serve God. Hallelujah. We need to believe God and think big. Hallelujah. When you have a God desire, it will pull you towards God and His way. How many know that God has His way? How many know we have our agenda? We think what we want to do. But how about what does God want us to do? I believe in the Word of God. I believe the Word of God is without error. I believe as you read the Word of God, you'll be a powerful person. You'll begin to do what God tells you to do. See, God told me to come with Pastor Edgy and sit under him. And today he's my pastor. I got to do what God wants me to do. Oh, I know how to do churches. I know how to pioneer. I know how to do all that. But can you take the back seat? You see, in Isaiah 55:8, for my thoughts are not your thoughts, Rudy, nor my ways your ways, says the Lord. We can't do our own thing. You're either doing God's thing or you're doing the devil's thing, but you can't do both. We must seek the Lord. We must turn to Him. We must turn to God in faith, and we must repent. And no one should delay in doing this. How many know we live a life that we don't like to repent? Oh, it's quiet. I love it when it's quiet, too. We don't like to repent, but we not delay it. Hallelujah. We must be diligent to seek Him in prayer, number one. Number two, in meditation on the Word. Number three, worship. And number four, discipline. Prayer is very important. You need to talk to the Lord. Lord, I'm jacked up. I'm messed up. God, I need you. God, I need you bad. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I need God bad every day. Number two, meditation. You need to meditate on the Word of God. Just one word. I like to meditate on repentance. Because when you need God and you're desperate for God, I'll tell you what, you'll meditate on His Word. Worship. Worship was awesome. I don't know about you, but I don't sing those oldies but goodies remind me of you. I don't sing here no more sitting on the bench with all the homeboys from the fence. I like when it says, Abba, I belong to you. When the sister's up here getting down, she's getting down. I belong to you. Who do you belong to? You need to get into the worship. You need to close your eyes and say, God, I belong to you. I don't belong to the world no more. I know how the world is. The world will mess you up. The world messed me up. Nobody's exempt from backsliding. Nobody. That's why it's very important to meditate on God's Word and worship God. And discipline. How many know that people say, oh man, that's so much discipline in the men's home. So much discipline in the women's home. I'm a product. Hallelujah. Of the men's home. Hallelujah. You got to be psycho. Hallelujah. Be in the men's home. Hallelujah. I mean, I love the men's home. I love the women's home. And I can see myself when I go there. Amen. Discipline. How many of it takes discipline reading the Bible? When you see movies on TV, when you're in Walmart, hallelujah, Home Depot, Costco's, but how about church? We need to come to church. We need to praise God. There's no coronavirus in church. You're not going to get coronavirus because the hand of God is upon you. Hallelujah. And you need to come back to church. Hallelujah. That's just free. Amen. That was a commercial. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Discipline. Getting here on time for prayer. Some people like to miss prayer, the worship, and just get to the word. It's important to be here on time. Can somebody say amen? Amen. Very important. Hallelujah. Discipline. Not only to come on Monday or before service or on Sunday, but how's your prayer life at home? When you're all by yourself and nobody's looking. If you're not, you don't speak in tongues, you need to get baptized in the Holy Spirit. Prayer is important. Discipline. Pastor wants me to do something. I said, yes, sir. I go to the doctor. Kidney transplant. I'm like the bionic preacher. Hallelujah. Liver's jacked up. Hallelujah. Can't hear. Hear voices. 5150. Hallelujah. I just tell him, shut up. Hey. Can somebody say Jesus? Jesus? Yes, sir. I'll make my appointments all around, but I'll get here on time. I'll do what you want me to do. Amen. How many know if you can give an order, can you take an order? I can give an order. I know how to be. Man, if you don't like it, I'll tell you, get on before you get stepped on. I know how to give an order, but can you take an order? And then from a youngster, can somebody say Jesus? See, all of us, we need help. All of us need help and walk with the Lord. I mean, we need help to walk with the Lord. That's why we come to church. That's why we pray. That's why we have discipline. Amen. That's why we come to hear from the Lord. Amen. That's why when people say, I want to tell you something, brother, you're walking the wrong way. Hey, sister, don't do that. Amen. Believe God and think big. We need to believe God. That's a good title, too, and think big. What am I going to do? My business, I'm thinking big for my business. I'm thinking big for my walk with the Lord. Amen. I want to do great things for God, but I want you to do great things. God wants you to do great things. God wants you to believe for your family. Your family's messed up. Their backs, they're in prison. You got to be big. They're coming out. They're going to serve God. My mom's not going to be on the streets. My dad's not going to be on the streets. My dad's going to be delivered, and you got to think big. Hallelujah. When they used to see Pastor Reggie, when he was from the hood, they go, oh, no, here he comes again. That's how they think about me and you. But now that we're in our right mind, hallelujah, we're walking for God. They welcome, here's Mr. Chacon. Well, come on in, Mr. Gallegos. I'll tell you what, they have respect for you. Why? Because you're serving the living God. You have thought big. You believe in God. You need to believe, hallelujah, all the way. You see, Enoch, he walked with God in the wicked world. How many know this world's wicked? Everybody goes anywhere else but church. You know the church, you know the devil's wicked. You know the world's wicked. Come on now. When we're in the world, I tell you, we show up to the hood or wherever you're at, the party, wherever you were, the life of the party. But I'll tell you what, we need to show up to the house of God. See, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Hallelujah. How many know we are covered by the blood of the Lamb? We're covered by the precious blood. I'll tell you what, 2,000 years ago, he died on the cross for you and I. Hallelujah. I'll tell you what, it's all about the blood. The blood of Jesus covers you. See, I don't have a spleen. I had a transplant. If anybody should stay home, it should be me. That's why I like Enoch. He walked with God in a wicked world before the flood came, the world was corrupt, just like today it's corrupt. Hallelujah. You can look at the world. You don't even have to look very far. You can look right here in Grand Terrace, Riverside, Paris, wherever you live at. It's jacked up. We need to preach the gospel. We need to get out there and reach people. Tell them about the goodness of God. Tell them they can get saved. Tell them that God loves them. Hallelujah. You and I, we got to go out to the corrupt world. Hallelujah. There's a walkathon. I hope you're signing up. Hallelujah. But Enoch was able to keep his life pure. How many know we can keep our life right? I know we're saved by grace. Can somebody say amen? Ephesians 2, 8 and 9. You ain't did nothing. Hallelujah. You can't do nothing to be good. Because how many know there ain't nothing good in us? The only goodness you have is Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. He's the one that keeps you. I can't keep you. The pastor can't keep you. The church can't. The only one that keeps you from falling is Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I'll tell you what. God is a good God. Hallelujah. And the devil's a bad devil. You see, Enoch was taken to heaven one day. He was translated. He was carried across and seen no more. How many know that one day, hallelujah, we talk about heaven. I tell you what, one day we won't be here. Amen. There's heaven, hallelujah, where there's no bills. There's no crying, hallelujah. I'll tell you what, where Jesus lives, hallelujah, the streets that go, one day we will be there. But nobody wants to leave, and nobody wants to die to get there. I look forward to heaven. I ain't worried. How many know when we're in the world, we're hope to die? You want to hope, kill me. And you jump up and down. Come back. And they come back and jack me up too. Hallelujah. Can somebody say Jesus? Jesus. We need to think big. We need to think big this year. What am I going to do for God? You see, God created you to do something for somebody else, to create something else in that other person. Like that young girl that plays the drums, hallelujah. She's down. She can play. She's anointed by God. How about you? What are you going to do? God created you to do something. Hallelujah. We need to think big. Souls. Souls. The souls of men and women. There's a real hell, friend. The souls of men and women. How about your own family? I got family that's not saved. And I pray for my family that they'll get saved. It's not us four no more. No. We need to pray for them. We need to get down. And then we need to live the life and be an example so they can follow the example. Pray that people will serve Jesus. God called you and I to believe him. We believe everybody else. You know what you need to hang around with? People that are in the word and praying. Amen. How many know there's a lot of negative people too? Say, I don't want to listen to no negative. Hallelujah. As it is, I'm negative, and I don't want to listen to no more negative. I'm trying to believe God, and you're trying to bring me down. Hallelujah. How many other people can bring you down? Say, hey, brother, you need to pray. Hey, sister, you need to pray. You see, we need to plug in to the source and rise up. The source, just like all this light, you got to plug in. You got to plug into God. Hallelujah. You got to plug in. He's the source. Amen. I'll tell you what, when you plug into God, I'll tell you what, you will be touched by God. Believe God and think big. God has purpose and a plan for each and every one of us. How many know there's purpose? We had no purpose before. Now we got purpose. You're saved. You're in your right mind. You're going forward. Hallelujah. With Jesus. Hallelujah. And I'll tell you what, you got purpose. There's a meaning to live now. I used to say, is this all there is to life? the barrio, going in and out of jail. Is this it? So somebody told me about Jesus Christ, how he could change my life. I said, if Jesus gives me a quebrada, I'll serve him. Ese. Told the pastor, I wasn't no Christian. I was a homie. All I looked out of my window, I see Kiki, Loco, and Sluggo, and Payasa, and Flaca. But God changed my life. Still changing me. How many know that God will change you from glory to glory? He changes you every day. Every day he's changing your life and my life. God has a plan. Psalms 32:8. I will instruct you and teach you in the way you shall go. And I will counsel you with my eye upon you. That's powerful. That's powerful, church. You see, that's why you need to learn the word. God will instruct you. He will tell you, hey, this is what I want you to do. That's why you all, Pastor, what I do. What do you do? Read the word and God will tell you. I will teach you. How many of you go, God is a teacher and he teaches very well. And he'll give you knowledge and he'll give you wisdom. In the way you should go. And I will counsel you. I went to marriage counseling. The marriage counselor said, you're too crazy. She told my wife, divorce him. He'll never change. And he was a Christian counselor. Hallelujah. She divorced me. Hallelujah. But she remarried me. And we did a great work for God. Hallelujah. God will counsel you. God will help you. God is our instructor and our teacher, and he will guide us. How many know that God will guide you? God will guide you into great and mighty things. God will guide you, but you got to want to walk and hold his hand. He will give us wisdom. He will give us wisdom. How many know we need wisdom? I don't know about you, but I need all the wisdom I can get because, you know, I'm stuck on stupid. Hallelujah. I'll tell you what, people say, hey, man, that guy must have bumped his head. I bump my head every day. I need wisdom. I don't know about you, but you better ask God for wisdom. You got to ask God for double wisdom. Hallelujah. He will not let us wander off. How many know that sometimes we want to wander off? I guess it's just the preacher. Hallelujah. That's why I'm in Living Word today. Hallelujah. God's eye is on you. How many know that God's eye? You see, people say, ah, nobody's looking. Hey, nobody's looking. God's eye is on you. Just like his eye was on David. King David, God's eye was on him. He was a man that was after God's own heart. Love God. Believe God and think big. Enoch lived a life that was demonstrated the faith that was in his heart. How much faith did you and I got to believe God and think big? Enoch had enough faith in his heart. You see, it's always a heart matter. Not the one that pumps blood. The real you, the real me. Is my heart beating for God? Do I want God bad? Am I desperate for him? There was a song that says, I'm desperate for you. I'm desperate for you, God. You got to get desperate. You see, the life of faith was a consistent and constant and complete walk with God. How many know we got to be consistent? You can't be missing one day and then come the other day and then, you know, I miss. You know what, I'll go next week. I'll go next year, you know. You got to be consistent. When you're in the Word, you're consistent. When I was in the world, I loved Mad Dog. I loved T-Bird. I was consistent at that liquor store, Chiquita's liquor store right there on Whittier Boulevard. I was consistent. And when my pastor told me when I got saved, he goes, be consistent in the things of God. That was Ruben Reyna that told me that. And don't be a chavala. In other words, don't be a crybaby. How many know sometimes we cry? Be consistent, Rudy. Hallelujah. And complete your walk with the Lord. See, his heart, believe God. His heart, believe. You got to believe God. I mean, we got to believe God big. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I got a lot of bills. I got a lot of things happening in my life. I got to believe God big. Hallelujah. Because I serve a big God. Hallelujah. The devil's a lot. My God is not little. Hallelujah. My God's a big God. If you serve a little God, you're in a whole lot of trouble. We need to think big. The Lord has plans. And God has plans for us. How many know that God has plans for you? God has a plan. Hallelujah. I don't know. I pioneered a lot of churches, been in a different country. I didn't know I was going to do all that. I don't even know how to take a plane. I don't even know how to do none of that. I didn't even know how to talk Spanish. I know how to cuss in Spanish, but I don't know how to talk Spanish. Send me all the way to Chile. It was chilly, too. Pioneered church. Hallelujah. Had a men's home. Hallelujah. But how many know that God did it? I'm not afraid. Yo no tengo miedo. Márrate. Come on now. If Pastor Edges wants to send me in, I'll go out. I'm 66, but I still got it. You got it. You got it. We were singing the song. You got it. You got it. Come on. You got it. In closing, believe God and think big. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not out to your own understanding. That's Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. I'm talking about God. I'm talking about Jesus. I'm talking about the Holy Ghost. He'll direct your path. Hallelujah. I'll tell you what, God is big. Hallelujah. Than any of your problems, than any of your circumstances, God is big. We need to believe him tonight. I'm not making this stuff up. This ain't like that song, Make Believe. This is real, friend. People need Jesus. What are you and I going to do about it? I told him, Pastor Edgy, put me on the street corner. We get down. Hallelujah. Believe God and think big, church. By December, this place is going to be packed out. Packed out. Hallelujah. Forget the coronavirus. Man, since I was 8 years old, I've been in different cities, different neighborhoods. They tell me, you can't be here. I said, you know, I'm going to be here anyway. I'm going to do what God called me to do. Do what God called you to do. Don't listen to the devil. Let's stand in the presence of God. Mighty God, I know your anointing is in this place. And then, mighty God, your grace and your mercy is upon every individual. And I pray this evening that you'll touch every heart, every situation. I don't know what they're going through, but I know you are. And you have a master plan, God, for every life. I pray, Father God, in 2022 that they look to you. And they'll be like Ratshack, Meshach, and Abednego. They'll only bow down to you and worship you and praise you, because you got something big for them and for their families and their loved ones. I pray that you'll shower us right now with your grace and your love and your mercy. Hallelujah. Maybe it's something that the Lord has spoken to you today, and you want to come up and you want to come to the altar and give your life and give it all to the Lord. See, the Lord is calling you. The Lord is calling you to greatness. The Lord is calling you. Will you respond to Him and let Him touch you, and that you won't be the same? This year you'll accomplish what He has called you to do. Hallelujah. It'll be a blessed year for you. All you got to do is respond to God. Get out of your seat and respond to the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, I have called you to do great and mighty things. If I be for you, who could be against you? Maybe you're not saved. You need to get saved. You're not saved. You need Jesus. I'll say a prayer with you. Hallelujah. If you're not saved, maybe you didn't want to come up, but you could say it right there where you're at. And this prayer goes like this. Dear Jesus, come into my heart. Forgive me of all my sins and wash me with your precious blood. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. Devil, you're a liar. Get out of my life. I renounce you in the name of Jesus. Now give the Lord a big clap offering. Begin to praise God. Begin to shout, because you've been set free. The Master has set you free. Hallelujah. Precious Father, Lord, the people that came up, I pray that you'll put a hedge of protection. I pray that you'll give them vision, your vision. I pray, Father God, that you'll continue to move in their very lives, and that they'll be men and women of prayer. They'll meditate on your word. And then, mighty God, you'll guide them and teach them great and mighty things. I pray in Jesus' name. And if they're sick, I pray that you'll heal them. Them that are watching, them that are at home, I pray that, Father God, that you'll heal them and touch them and make them whole in Jesus' name. And I give you all the glory and all the honor. And I thank you, Lord, for my pastor, Edgy, and his wife, Sonia. God bless you. Let's sing a song if we can.
Darkest stories that have proved your faithfulness, and I've seen miracles my mind can't comprehend. There is beauty in what I can understand. Jesus, it's you. Jesus, it's you. I believe the wonder-working God. You're the wonder-working God. All the miracles I see, too good to not believe. You're the wonder-working God. You heal because you love. Oh, the miracles we'll see, too good to not believe.
We had an awesome service. Lives were touched. Hearts were changed. I'm telling you, God is on the move, church. And we're grateful for you plugging in and staying connected with us. We know what we have a lot of different avenues where you can watch us on. You can watch us on Facebook. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can watch us on Instagram and allow God to minister to you and keep you connected on what we're doing next and on what's taking place and what's going on here at Living Word. And so we're excited because we're seeing God move and we're seeing God just touch lives and God just doing miraculous things. And with your love and with your support and with you just allowing yourself to connect here, God wants to use you to make a difference and make a difference in your family, in your job, in your workplace. The message that God has spoken to you, the message that you've heard, is going to help you and build you to become that man of God and that woman of God you were called to be. Maybe you're saying, Pastor, well, I didn't have that chance to say that prayer. I was too embarrassed, or I was struggling to let go of some stuff, but I'm ready now. And so if you're ready now and you're ready to give your heart to God, I want you to say this simple prayer with me. Say, Jesus, forgive me of all my sins. Come into my heart and make me new. Thank you for forgiving me of all my sins. In Jesus' name, amen. That simple prayer has saved you, delivered you, set you free from your past, from the guilt, from the shame. And I'm telling you, now it's our job to stay plugged in, get involved, read your Bible, and to stay away from the things of evil that get you caught up. I'm telling you, great futures ahead of you, great purpose are ahead of you, and we want to be part of that. Maybe you want to comment or leave us a message or send us a information. We want to help you on your journey, on your new journey with the Lord. And so we're grateful for you. We love you here at Living Word, and we are grateful for you guys. Also, we want you to know we have rehab centers for men and women, those who need help or those that are just tired and going through stuff, and maybe you need just a little bit more than that. Come to our centers. God will help you. God will do great things in you. Great men and women have come out of that. And I'm telling you, I came out of that center. God changed my life 28 years ago, and I haven't been the same. And we want to do the same for families and friends out there who don't know God and want to know who God is. So we're excited. Come connect with us. Know what's going on. See what's going on here at Living Word. We love you. God bless you. And remember, with God, all things are possible.
We were so blessed to have you join us today at Living Word Inland Empire. If you would like to hear more of today's message, head on over to our podcast and search Living Word IE. We want to thank you for joining us. And if you would like to watch more sermons, be sure to follow us on Facebook and YouTube. Again, thank you so much for joining us. And we can't wait to see you for our next service.